It proves that Ingram didn't invent the story, as many have suggested, and that he was recounting some sort of actual terrifying event on the Bell Farm decades earlier. And if the spirit still exists, the farm is the most likely place to make contact. So, as daylight starts to fade, we make our way to the cornfield, just like John Bell did in 1817, right before a hellhound paid him a visit.
Oh, this corn is so thick.
Ah, I'm already getting smashed in the face.
Oh, all right, made it to the tree.
Look at this. I see the well.
That's the Bell family well.
This is the only thing left from the original John Bell house.
Yeah.
Where everything began.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to see how deep this thing is. Oh, that is deep.
We should investigate it.
Yeah.
Some believe that spirits can attach themselves to everything from people to property. If the Bell's home played host to the witch, and if her presence also exists underground, then this well is all she's got left, a portal between the farm and the other side.
You got my line?
I got your line.
Okay. All right, going down.
A supernatural portal? I'm not so sure about that. But it is the only remaining part of the original Bell farmstead, and I want to get a first-hand look.
Weird.
What, what, what?
Holy there are, like, big scratch marks in here. Seeing them here, 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 like, something was trying to climb out of here. God, that's disgusting. There's hair.
Oh.
It looks more human than animal. What the happened down here?
If you can bring any of that up, bring it up with you.
Yeah.
Phil.
Yeah.
Hurry up. I just heard something rustling around close to us.
All right. Got too much slack. You gotta pull it tight.
All right.
All right, pull more.
Okay.
You okay up here?
I straight up heard something out here. I feel like somebody is here.
Let me show you what I got. Pretty gross hair.
Oh, okay, you can hold that. I don't need to hold that. That's great. This is creepy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's see if we can figure out where that noise is coming from.
We push even deeper into Bell family territory. David Britton also talked about nearby grave sites on the property.
There's graves and remnants of a well, and that's about it.
If the Bell witch tormented John and Lucy Bell in life, perhaps she still haunts them in death. So we make our way to the Bellwood Cemetery.
It is so creepy in here.
This place is, oh, it's weird.
Oh, I found it.
You found it for sure?
Absolutely for sure.
All right, can you shine your light, holler a little bit, I'll come your way.
All right, I'm over here.
What you got?
Check this out.
Oh my gosh. John Bell,
mm-hmm.
1750 to 1820.
Yeah, and his wife, Lucy.
This is the spot.
Yeah. Is it?
Something's in the bushes over there. Something big. I've seen some eyes. No. I saw something for sure.
Maybe she's watching us.
There's something out there with eyes shine. And it took off.
Ingram's book says that the sighting of a supernatural creature often precedes an attack from the witch. From the cave to the burial site of John and Lucy Bell, and into the expansive cornfields on this property, it seems like something has been stalking us. And if we're going to make contact with the Bell witch, it's going to be right here tonight.
All right, well, let's set it up.
We find a small clearing in the corn and set up various trigger items. An old photo of the Bell farmhouse and a candle similar to the one we found in the cave might elicit a response from the Bell witch. We're also rigging infrared motion sensors around the area. If a spirit, an animal, a ghost, a witch, if anything passes by, we're gonna know about it.
All right, call me on the walkie if anything happens.
We're splitting up to cover more ground. Today, the land is a maze of endless rows of corn.
I swear, it is so hard to see anything in here.
I'm pretty deep in the field. I'm gonna go ahead and sit down here and see if I can communicate with the Bell Witch.
Copy that.
I'm using a device that scans radio frequencies and white noise that many believe spirits can use to communicate with.
Are you still at the Bell Farm? Kate, is that you? Kate, is that you? Do you hear that? It's like it's moving around us.
I just heard something moving in the corn. Whoa. Jess, did you hear that?
It sounded like a voice to me.
If it's a person, then why the hell can't we see it? You got anything on the thermal?
I don't see a thing.
If it was the Bell Witch, is that you making that noise? Did you hear that? Phil, are you there?
Yeah, go ahead.
So I just said, if you are the Bell Witch, did you make that noise? And the ghost box said, yes, yes.
What? Are you sure?
Phil, are you there?
What's happening?
I hear that noise again, and it's really close this time.
It's right by me.
Yeah, I think I just heard it.
I'm going after it.
Me too. What is this thing?
Okay, something was loud. Where was it?
It was right next to me. It sounded like something was coming through the cornfield, and it was close.
She knocked the candles out?
No.
I didn't hear the sensors go off. Definitely heard something in the corn and the candles out. Mm-hmm. With essentially zero wind here tonight.
We just got some responses. We're not calling it a night.
Okay, let's keep at it.
All right.
We continue to search the cornfields and graveyards at the old Bell Farm, but whatever was lurking and whispering in the shadows has fallen silent. The sun about to rise, we finally make our way back to the main road.
The story of the Bell Witch was popularized by the work of M.V. Ingram, but was he reporting on true events? With this legend, the lines between fact and folklore seem to blur between the edges. Was the voice that seemingly spoke to Jess simple radio interference, or Kate Batts trying to make contact from beyond the grave?
Did you hear that? It said yes, yes.
More questions left unanswered.
Don't get me wrong. We saw some weird stuff, heard some weird stuff from the cave to the cornfield.
In a local cave, the team found evidence of animal activity and also potential ritual items, but also heard what sounded like a voice. At John and Lucy Bell's grave and in the cornfield, something seemed to be hiding in the shadows.
I just heard something moving in the corn.
Lab analysis of the evidence Phil collected in the well concluded the hair sample was in fact human. How and why it got down there is anybody's guess. But one thing is certain. New documents confirm that a ghostly presence has at least been reported on the Bell property for two centuries.